Before beginning this lesson, I'm going to give you a brief tour of all of the horizontal alignment options available in Excel 2013. First of all, let's consider the general alignment option. This is the default format applied to cells when you haven't applied any specific format yourself. Look at the values in cells E7 to G7. You can see that because these values are text, they're aligned to the left of the cell. But now look at the numeric values in cells E8 to G10. They're aligned by default to the right-hand side of the cell. In lesson 4.1, you learnt about date serial numbers, and you know that dates are really numbers behind the scenes. So it will come as no surprise to see that the dates in cells B8 to B10 are also right aligned. Let's now left align all of the values in column E. So I first select column E by clicking in the column header, and then Home tab on the ribbon, and in the alignment group, I'll click the Align Left button. When I click, the values in cells E8 to E10 are also left aligned. Now I want to talk about how text is truncated when it's left aligned. And to demonstrate this, I'll make column C a lot narrower. First of all, look at the text in cell C2. You can see that because there's no value in cells D2 and E2, the text is spilling across into the empty cells, and I can still read all of the text in cell C2. But in the case of cell C3, there is a value in cell D3, and that's causing the text to be truncated on the right-hand side. In cell C4, it doesn't matter that there's a value to the left of cell C4, because text never spills left when it's left aligned, so I can still read all of the text. And in cell C5, the situation is the same as in cell C3. The text is being truncated on the right-hand side. I'm now going to look at the Align Center option. To do that, I'll first resize column C so that it's wide enough to display all of the contents. Then I'll select all of the cells in column C by clicking on the column header. And then I'll click Home tab on the ribbon, and in the alignment group, Center. When I click Center, the text in each cell is aligned in the center of the cell. Let's now look at how center-aligned text is truncated. I'll make column C a lot narrower, and notice that the value in cell C2 is now spilling both to the left and to the right of the cell, because cells B2 and D2 are empty. Now let's look at the text in cell C3, and you can see that the text is being truncated on the right-hand side because of the value in cell D3. But on the left-hand side, the text is still spilling left into the empty cell B3. Now let's look at the text in cell C4, and you can see that C4 is being truncated on the left-hand side because of the value in cell B4. But it's still spilling into the empty cell D4. And if we now look at cell C5, you can see that the text is being truncated on both sides because there's a value in cells B5 and D5. Now let's horizontally align the text in column C to the right of the cells. I'll first make column C wide enough to display all of the contents. Then I'll select all of the values in column C by clicking on the column header. And then I'll click Home tab on the ribbon. And in the alignment group, I'll click Align Right. You can see that the text in each cell is now aligned to the right of the cell. Let's now look at how right-aligned text is truncated. So once again, I'll make column C a lot narrower. If we look at the value in C2, you can see that it now spills to the left because of the empty cell B2. In cell C3, it also spills to the left because of the empty cell B3. And it doesn't matter that there's a value in cell D3 when you right-align text. In cell C4, you can see that the text is being truncated on the left-hand side due to the value in cell B4. And exactly the same thing is happening in cell C5, where the value in cell B5 is causing the text to be truncated on the left-hand side. I'm now going to look at a very unusual type of horizontal alignment, and that is to justify text within a cell. Justified text is the kind of text you find in newspapers and paperback books, when both the left-hand and right-hand side of the text align with left-hand and right-hand side of the page. Let's begin by resizing column C so that it's wide enough to display all of the contents of the cells. And I'm going to justify the text in cell C12. Now, the text in C12 is a little different to any text you've seen in a cell before, and that's because there's more than one line of text within the cell. This is called wrapped text, and you're going to learn all about wrapped text in the next lesson, lesson 4-6. But I need to introduce it at this stage just to show you how the justified feature works. I'll click on cell C12, and because justified is an advanced feature, we don't have any justified alignment option on the ribbon. We need to do this by bringing up the Format Cells dialog. I can either do this by right-clicking the selected cell and select Format Cells from the shortcut menu, or I can use the Dialog Launcher button on the bottom right of the alignment group on the ribbon. Either way, the Format Cells dialog is displayed. I need to make sure the Alignment tab is selected, and you can see all of the horizontal alignment options that we've already encountered, along with a few new ones, and one of them is Justify. I'll now click Justify and then OK. And you can see that the text in cell C12 now looks similar to the text you might see in a newspaper or a paperback book. There are two other quite unusual horizontal alignment options that I'll cover just for completeness, though you may find that you never have a use for these two options in real-world worksheets. The first is the Distribute option. I'll click in cell C2, then right-click and Format Cells, and then in the Horizontal drop-down, I'll select Distributed. When I click OK, you can see that each of the words in the sentence are equally spaced across the width of column C. And if you make column C wider or narrower, the gaps will increase so that the words continue to have identical spacing. Once again, I've never found a real-world use for this in my own workbooks. Now we look at an option that was widely used in some very old versions of Excel, but is rarely used today, and that's the fill format. I'll demonstrate that in cell C14. So I'll right-click on cell C14, select Format Cells from the shortcut menu, and in the Horizontal Alignment drop-down, I'll select Fill. When I click OK, you can see that the word cat in cell C14 is repeated for the entire width of the cell. And if I make the cell narrower, the number of words decreases, and if I make it a lot wider, it will increase. Now you might wonder why we ever wanted to use this, even in earlier versions of Excel. And the answer is we used to use it for fancy underlines. I'm going to type an asterisk and a plus sign into cell C16 and then press the Enter key. Now I'll right-click on the cell and bring up the Format Cells dialog. I'll click the Alignment tab, and in the Horizontal Alignment drop-down, I'm going to select Fill. And you can see that this results in a sort of a fancy underline. But because Excel 2013 has very sophisticated underline and drawing features, it's unlikely you'll ever find a use for the fill format. Now that you have an overview of all of the horizontal alignment options available in Excel 2013, let's continue with the lesson. For this lesson, you need to open the sample file, Sales Week Ended 14th of March 2008-3 from your sample files folder. Notice that the text in row 1 doesn't align with the column contents. You can see this most clearly in column G, where the word total doesn't align with the values beneath. But if I was to widen some of the other columns, you can see the problem much more clearly. It would be nice to align the text in cells E1 to G1 so that it matched the right alignment of the values beneath. So I'll select cells E1 to G1 and then click Home on the ribbon and in the alignment group, Align Right. I'm sure you'll agree that that looks a lot better. We also have the same problem in columns A and columns B. So let's also take cells A1 to B1 and click Home, Alignment on the ribbon, and Align Right. It's normal to align column headers that are above numeric values or dates on the right-hand side of the cell, and textual values, such as the customer in cell C1, on the left-hand side of the cell. To improve the appearance of the worksheet, I'm now going to boldface all of the values in row 1. So I select row 1 by clicking the row 1 row header, and then home on the ribbon, and in the font group, I'll click the bold button. Let's now resize all of the cells in the body of the worksheet so that they're just wide enough for their contents. You learnt how to do this in lesson 2.9. I'll select cells A1 to G17 and then click Home on the ribbon and in the cells group format and then Autofit column width. And all of the values in the body of the worksheet are now the correct width for their contents. All that remains now is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name Sales Week Ended 14th of March 2008-4. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed lesson 4.5, Horizontally Align the Contents of Cells.